suppose Abe Andrews told you I was here.
Yeah, well, you wouldn't have thought to let me know, would you?
Why should I? You'd never care what happened to me before.
And you haven't exactly been the loving daughter ever since I had you.
Happy families. Reminds me of when I was a kid. All the fellas at the pub said to say hello, Georgie.
Oh, great. Hey, down a drink for me, will ya?
Oh, charming. If this is the sort of company you keep, it's no wonder you ended up where you are.
Oh, rack off your old bag. You never done nothing for me. I can use my own friends.
Yeah, you can't talk. The only reason you haven't gone inside is because you make enough bread to pay off the pigs.
I don't have to stay and listen to this.
I don't want it came in the first place.
What's going on in here? I can hear the row halfway down the corridor.
I'm just leaving. I don't know why I thought that ungrateful brat would be pleased to see me.
Mrs. Baxter, I'm David Andrews. I spoke to you on the phone.
Oh, I shouldn't have bothered listening. Oh, and if you've got any other little schemes to brighten up poor Georgina's day, do me a favour. Don't tell me, huh?
Rack off!
Georgina needs a rest. You better go too.
Sure. Just splitting anyway. See you, Fink.
Yeah. See ya.
See you, Doc. See you, Teach.
Mike.
And you settle down, young lady. I'm surprised you're not in pain after all that shouting. Not too long, eh?
I guess I owe you an apology.
Yeah, what'd you ask that old bag to come for anyway?
Well, I thought it might help.
Yeah, well, I knew there'd be a blue. There always is with her and me. I told ya.
Sorry. Perhaps I'd better get my ears tested as well, eh?
Yeah, maybe.
The doctor's pleased with the results of the op. Those tests they gave you this morning show that your hearing's really improved.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry if I was a bit of a rat bag before.
Oh, forget it. Now that we've got to the root of your problem, all we've got to do is clear up the other things, like proving to everyone that you weren't stupid, just a bit deaf.
Yeah.
Well, I better be going.
Teach, thanks a lot.
G'day, love. You're home early. No overtime today.
No.
It's the truth. I just spent $9 in that shop. There's hardly anything there.
How'd you go at the employment office?
Like there reckons I stood buckleys of getting a job.
And they reckon there's work around if you want it.
Yeah. Should have stayed inside. I was doing all right running that book. It'll be a fortnight before my first check arrives. Thank God you're bringing something in.
Well, it ain't much.
Yeah, but it's something, isn't it? We're going to have to be real careful for a while.
Look, love. There's something I've got to tell you.
What?
I had a blue with a form in the Savo.
You never got the sack.
No, I walked out.
You stupid bugger. Don't worry, love. It's not the end of the world. It just means I'll have to get me money from B sooner than I thought. Margot! Look, I know I'm not supposed to be here, Mrs. Morris, but I've got to see B.
Now, you know that's not allowed.
Couldn't you swing it, please? It's real important.
Well, you better tell me what it's about.
Oh, just need her advice, that's all.
Bees?
Yeah, well, she's got lots of ideas about things. See, I'm in a bit of a spot. I know it's just rotten luck, but Wayne went and lost his job and, well, we're broke. I've been to see about the doll, but it's going to take about 2 weeks.
How do you expect Bee to help?
Well, she might be able to tell me where I can get a job or something.
What about the money you left here with?
We had a few expenses.
Oh, there must be a way to cut through the red tape. Look, you leave it with me. I'll phone the CES and see if they can hurry things along.
Oh, that's terrific. Thanks. But, could you still tell B I'll drop by to see her?
All right. I'll be in touch.
Thanks, Mrs. Morris.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then.